Hi, my name's Lara O'Neill and Maeve Murray is here with me and she's a PE teacher. Thank you for coming and doing the interview with me. So we're going to start off with a few questions. Where did you grow up and what was your childhood like?
I grew up in Cullyhanna, just outside, obviously outside Cross McGlynn, South Armagh. My childhood is very happy. I come from a very big family and I lived on a farm, so a lot of hard work and a lot of graft and things like that. And I'm the youngest of my family, so three older brothers who gave me a tough time to start, but you know, yeah. Very, very good. Good fun.
So who's your sporting hero growing up?
You have to remember, Lara, I grew up in the 1990s. Okay, yeah. There wasn't very much TV going around at that time, and at that time, you're lucky, you know, you've had a lot of Gaelic mm-hmm. football like, yeah. and all of that yeah. at the moment with Armagh. Mm-hmm. Very little of that. My time of day, Camogie was one of the main sports that I would have played when I was younger. But at that time, we were very big in my family into tennis. And we used to have our summers that were spent watching Wimbledon and then mm-hmm. going out and trying to replicate your yeah. who you saw on the TV. So I suppose maybe my sporting hero when I was around that age might have been somebody like Steffi Graf. At that time, Steffi Graf was the main woman. She was winning the Grand Slams, she was going out with Andre Agassi at that time, we thought was a babe, so we thought she was just brilliant. And I remember every time watching her, trying to emulate her whenever I played against all of my family and trying to ace and all of that. So really that was who my sporting icon was at that mm-hmm. time, that time in my life.
And who or what influenced you to get involved in the sport?
I suppose family, and I mean extended family, was a big thing when I was younger. Especially in primary school, we would have played a lot of sport. You know, PE was my favourite subject in primary school, yeah. you know. And I suppose a lot of it was, as I said, Gaelic games, cross country, mm-hmm. Camogie especially. So I would have played a lot of underage Camogie for my local club, St Patrick's in Cullyhanna. And then obviously cousins and friends like that, we would have kept on yeah. with that. And I suppose then it didn't really develop further until I went into secondary school, and you had this class called PE, you know, an hour and a half dedicated to PE. I yeah. thought all my Christmases had come, I thought it was brilliant. And I suppose that was the outlet, you know, that there was an idea that you could stay for yeah. after school sport, mm-hmm. and I just thought it was the best thing ever. So I suppose it was a big influence in my family, and then it was also the teachers in school who said, you know, give it a go, try it out. And I really started to love and try different sports, like athletics yeah. And netball, a wee bit of basketball. So I just love that.
At what age did you start playing netball and become interested in the sport?
Funny enough, netball, we played that in primary school. I don't know how I came into Cullyhanna, but netball, I don't know who it started or yeah. netball. We started to sort of, it was a game for girls at my mm-hmm. primary school. So P6, I remember somebody asking me to join in with the P7s and sort of got a hang of the rules and started to play it. So 10, I started an idea what this netball was.
Yeah.
And then when you were after the 11 plus in P7 and stars, I started to get in, you know, and doing your P. It was netball for the girls and football for the boys. So we started playing netball quite regularly, and I suppose my P7 teacher at the time had organised a match with our local primary school, which was Cross McGlynn, so St Patrick's mm-hmm. Cross McGlynn, and we had to play this big match against them. So mm-hmm. trained and trained to play this one match, and it was just the best match of my life. So obviously played that, and I just thought it was the bee's knees. So yeah. much so that, as I said, I took home the netball kit, which probably was older than me, had photographs taken of it, just thought it looked brilliant. First time I've ever had a kit,
yeah.
and I still have those photographs, and just thought it was just brilliant, you know, yeah. playing these positions, you know, it was just great. And then when I get into Sacred Heart Grammar School, it was my secondary school, and there was this idea about, okay, everybody, all the first years come and trial for the first year netball yeah. team. And of course I had a head up, I knew what I was talking about. So I started to play, and I remember my PE teacher at the time, Sister Julie, put her hand on my shoulder and said, "Will you come to after school netball?" I was hooked. You know,
yeah.
that was it. Tuesdays after school, that was me. You know, mm-hmm. Tuesday after school, I played netball every Tuesday. And God forbid if I couldn't do it. You know, I remember the time I had to get, as everybody does, braces. A lot yeah. of my appointments were on maybe, no, had not to be on a Tuesday. Could be any other day of the week except a Tuesday, because I didn't want to miss my
yeah.
netball training. And at those times, you know, it was outdoors on the tarmac court.
Mm-hmm.
which is not great when you think about everything. And you know, so it was, but it toughened you up a wee bit.
Yeah.
So I remember I just loved it, and I used to take the posts from down up in the room and into the gym and take them down and play, and you practice, and you just practice. And then that was it on a Tuesday. And so I really got into netball there when I got into school, because my school was into it.
Yeah.
I started to play a team sport that way.
Mm-hmm. What experiences have you got out of playing netball?
Big experiences, you know, positives,
yeah,
and negatives. You know, sport's a big motivator, and it's also a big life experience, any sort of sport. So when I started to play, obviously you want to win. You want to firstly,
yeah,
make the team. You want to do yourself proud, your parents proud, and your teacher proud, or your coach
mm-hmm.
proud. And I suppose that was it, a wee bit ambition, you know, ambition
mm-hmm.
to be the best and to win matches. Experiences-wise, you know, learning from your mistakes, learning, you know, pick yourself up, play on. You know, I remember the early days going for possibly my first trial for a regional development academy. It was totally blown out of the water. I didn't know it was such a big opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember being disappointed that I hadn't made that team that year, because I felt I let my coach down.
Yeah.
She had put me forward, just met myself and another girl. And, you know, I thought, I need to do better. So
yeah.
I learned, you know, it wasn't that, okay, then that's not for me. I thought, you know, try better, try
yeah.
harder. And I suppose, obviously, it's the catharsis, the stress relief. You know,
yeah.
you might have, I know now when I'm playing, you forget about your work, you forget about issues that you
mm-hmm.
may be going on in your head. It's great when you're playing with your teammates, and you know, the wee bit of fun that you have, the
yeah.
bit of crack that you have between your friends, and it's great way that way, a wee bit of a stress reliever. And experiences as well, positive, as I said, you know, winning matches, you know, winning
mm-hmm.
leagues, winning cups, winning plates, it's fantastic, you know, opportunity when you're winning. And I suppose some of the big experiences I've loved is coaching. You know, I've transitioned into coaching hopefully well, done well, and I really enjoyed it. So I think, you know, now as a player coach, I love those experiences, and watching young girls, you know, do the same thing I have over the years,
yeah.
you know, get into a sport and really, you know, really enjoy, you know, playing together, making new friends, you know, just
yeah.
because you're from this place or from that, you know, school, but you have other friends,
yeah.
and it's just fantastic to be in that opportunity. So that's why sort of the experiences, it opens up new doors for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
I feel that's what
yeah,
I feel about it. I found some of it myself, so that
yeah.
was it.
Where did you train when you were younger, and what were the facilities like?
Oh dear me, the facilities. I suppose, as I said, I started in school, and my school, we had it, as I said, outdoor courts.
Yeah.
So you know, the gravel, tarmac, you know, footwork, as you know, is one of the rules in netball, and don't know how I'm going for footwork more, but sliding on that
yeah.
course. But as we got, you know, older and better, and gratefully our teacher took us down to train in Newry Sports Centre. So we used to train in that, you know, that big court that's
yeah.
in there, and it was brilliant, because it meant then obviously you developed, and as I got taller and stronger, you were able to deliver
mm-hmm.
a faster ball, a harder ball, and then play a lot, and be a lot fitter, play a lot better.
Yeah.
So we started training that facility for school. And then when I first started playing for Newry Ladies, I was 17, and again it was training in Newry Sports Centre, only netball court that there was at that time,
yeah.
and it was great, you know, great to have that facility in Newry. When I started to play for Northern Ireland, the facilities we had, we also travelled to Belfast, and one of the facilities we had to go to was Strathearn School, which was, to me, it could have been Marsh. I didn't know where Strathearn School was, we had the outer ring of Belfast. And it was a school court, and it was fantastic. It was the Manchester United of, you know, school netball courts. It was fantastic and a brilliant place for us to train to play. Another place for the league I trained on was another school, early St Patrick's School in Knock. Again, could have been Saturn. I don't know where it was,
yeah.
but it was another good facility for us to play in. So a few different places that I've played in, you know, when I first started playing netball, really.
Do you have different feelings every time you step onto the court?
Certainly do, Laura, yes. I suppose when I first started playing netball, I would have had a lot more nerves than I do now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm playing netball, I hate to think about it, but over 20 years now. So when I first started playing, it was pure motivation, you know,
yeah.
pure passion, pure excitement. And as I probably transitioned into the more serious end, when I was sort of 17, 18, 19, 20, playing at a very, very, very high level, it would have been, you know, pure commitment, you know, and you have your team, your tactics in your mind, you have a job to do, your coach is giving you that issue. So the feeling of that, you know, playing against big teams like England, or even, you know, even the older age group in Northern Ireland was tough, and you knew that it was a lot of pressure on you, and especially when you get to that high level, there's a lot of, you know, I've been cut from a number of squads, and I know what that feeling's like, so it's that kind of feeling of, I need to do my best here. I suppose when I play for my club, a lot of it is, you know, trying to win for your club, for your teammates, and trying to do your best. Every time you step on court, it might be a different feeling. Sometimes I feel like, I need to win this because, you know, this will mean promotion, or this will mean we'll win the league. Or other times it might be, I want to win this because I know that they beat us the first half and we can beat them, and I'm better than that person. And again, that is a part of it, is obviously confidence, and you need to have, obviously, confidence develops as you get older. And some of it is just tiredness when you get older. It might just think, oh, here we go again, I'll do my best. And a lot of it you do when you get older, you find that you rely a lot on experiences and their tactics. So when I was younger, I would have done a lot more running than I do now, it seems. So you do have those different types of feeling and motivations and stuff. And I think you become more motivated when with a team is more cohesive and a team that you've been a part of for numerous years. So the team I'm currently with, our senior year ladies, we're very close, we're very together, and as every time it's enjoyment when you step on court to play for them. You want to do well for the team.
Looking back, is there anything you do differently or anything that you regret, and why?
Looking back, I suppose, you know, I suppose where I lived, you talk about the distance to get into Newry from where I live, where I lived in Collyhanna. I would have loved to have joined a club sooner than what I did, you know. Our Newry Ladies Netball Club had been around when I was at school, but just due to the distance and their training times, it was very difficult for me to get in the evenings. You know, I wouldn't be at home in Collyhanna until 5 o'clock, you know, coming from school, and then the pressures of studies and etc. So whenever I did join them when I was 17, that was because I had to be part of a club, to be part of a Northern Ireland squad. I had to then have my dad, who's working all day on the farm, to try and drive me in, wait around for 2 hours, watching a sport he didn't know too much about, to play. So I would have loved to have joined the club earlier if I had, I don't know, lived closer to one. You know, I'd love to have joined that, and because I can see what you guys have. You know, you have been part of a club for a number of years, and that helps you develop and more ambitious, you know, and you'd be more confident, I think, you know, coming forward. It's more cohesion when you're in a team with a lot of your friends. I suppose maybe professionally and in my career, I'd love to have gone forward more and stuck at the sort of higher level sport end a lot more. Don't regret a lot of things, you know, a lot of pressure's going on when you do be at university, and I'm delighted to know how it worked out in the third level education, but at that time, I would have loved to have been possibly more committed to that end, and working harder at fitness and skills and things like that. Not really regretting it. I just, it would have been a different course for me. Because obviously, as you know, I met you at the Commonwealth Games. Both of us were watching Northern Ireland, and we picked up, you know, came 8th in the Commonwealth Games. Fantastic achievement. And watching those girls, they were all my teammates. They were all my friends who were my age. You know, were playing for their country in the Commonwealth Games. Phenomenal achievement for a lot of my friends, and you know, it was, but you know, a lot of those girls deserve that, you know, to win. And obviously, you know, one of my very, very close friends, Hannah Willis, now was obviously the captain of that team, and I was just delighted for her because she would have been the same age group if I was playing and training, and so much commitment required for those girls to get to that stage. And I'm just delighted for them. You go to, sometimes you think, oh, maybe I could have been there. But again, you know, it's another life, another time. So you would have liked to have seen that.
Would you rather coach netball or would you rather play?
Oh, good question. I suppose I loved what I got into netball. I love playing netball. If someone said to me tomorrow you can't play netball anymore, I would be very disappointed. You know, I think I'd be gutted because I love the sport. But as regards to whether I'd rather play or coach, I do love coaching. I love working with young players. I love working with that and with girls. And I love developing a team, developing somebody's skills, getting them to, you know, their potential, whether it be, you know, shooting when they can't shoot, or bringing their fitness up or winning the league, you know, or getting into a squad. And I suppose possibly my priorities have changed since I have changed and become older and obviously become a PE teacher. So I suppose possibly now I do love coaching netball more. And I suppose you can say I live through the younger players. I love to see them. And, you know, I go support you guys whenever you're at your games or your development tournaments, because I know I'm proud of watching you guys. I know I was there at your age, and nothing made me feel better than watching and looking at somebody, my coach or my teacher, looking on and supporting me. So I love that. So I suppose possibly love coaching. Love coaching. Yeah. Love coaching.
Is there a moment that stands out with you of all your years involved in sport?
Just the one, Lara. I suppose possibly playing. If I talk about playing first, I suppose a big thing that really stood out for me at the highest point of my netball career, if you can want to call it that, was when I said when I was 19 and I was with the Northern Ireland team, and we were in England and we were playing in the Manchester Velodrome. So Manchester, before that, had held the Commonwealth Games, and we were playing in the Velodrome, so sort of in the inner court there.
Yeah.
And I was captain of that team, and it was just a special day for me. We were playing against a very good English team, and you know, I just felt my role as a captain. I really, really appreciated the role that my coach had given to me, and I'd been part of that squad for a couple of years.
Yeah.
So, and it just was a great, you know, to have that experience, where a lot of my friends didn't have those experiences. So to step on court and to play that, I loved it. And I know, and then I suppose possibly after that, I was named Players Player by my squad, and I was given a mascot, and I still have that mascot now, and you know, it means a lot to me.
Yeah.
That I suppose playing now, another highlight would be winning, you know, the senior plate last year with my club, with Newry. You know, up until last year we were in a wee bit of a transition period, and a lot of players just couldn't commit anymore, and there's a lot of younger players coming in, so it took us a wee while just to get back into the potential that we have. You know, Newry had great potential. I suppose last year we were playing really well. We were working together as a team, and we just won the league, the Southern League, and it came to us playing for the Northern Ireland Plate, and a lot of excitement, a lot of build up to it. And I suppose playing that day and winning that match and winning the Northern Ireland Plate and lifting the Northern Ireland title of the plate, and looking around and seeing a lot of girls who were my teammates, were my past pupils, or girls who had come through our junior club. Who still call me Miss on the court. So it was very good, and I always keep that medal, you know. It means more than what it really is. It's not just winning a match, it's winning a battle with that. I suppose that's what I really appreciate. Coaching wise, probably there's a number of things that stand out, you know. I suppose coaching, when I first started coaching a regional academy, so I would have taken on board the under 15 Southern area. And there's so much potential in the area for young girls and for sport, so much skill. And it's a big commitment for myself, because I was travelling to Craigavon, which is about 45 minutes away from where I was living. And at that time, coaching girls, you had to meet them, you know, once a month and get them together. And I suppose what I really loved about one particular time in 2010 was that we actually won the Northern Ireland Youth Games, which was a phenomenal achievement for the Southern area.
Yeah.
We were, you know, at that time, and why it was such a big thing was we had some good potential players, you know, from different schools. And when we came together on that Saturday, it came to the last match, you know, it came right down. If we drew against possibly the North East, and if we had to win this South East match, if we didn't win it, we would come third, not even second. So the big thing, and I just know the girls really, really wanted it. And I suppose when the final whistle blew and we had won, it was just elation. You would have thought we won the World Cup. And I was just so proud of those girls, delighted. And then it turned out those girls started to come too, and that's why I set up Newry League's netball club, junior club. Those girls started to come in from around the Newry area, and we started to develop. That was one of the first under 16 teams, because that's, you know, they were coming and had got so much success from that. I suppose another highlight this year, Lara, has to be our Northern Ireland Plate win for school.
Brilliant.
We were sort of thinking to get to that one.
Yeah.
I suppose the reason why that really stood out for me, Lara, you have to remember, I've been coaching you guys for a number of years, both school and outside, in school and outside of school, and I suppose a lot of you guys girls have worked really, really hard. And it's hard, we're a small school, and Sperry's High School is a smaller school, And to get to a Northern Ireland final is a phenomenal achievement,
yeah,
in itself.
Fabulous.
And the way we got to it, you know,
yeah,
was very tight. And it does, it doesn't, you know, you can have individuals who are super, but you need to have a team that works
mm-hmm.
together.
Yeah,
and I suppose whenever we train so hard,
yeah,
and it was fantastic the opportunities we got from past pupils of ours, past pupils of mine,
yeah,
club girls that were involved with Newry, who came and helped and put up challenge fixtures for yourself
mm-hmm.
to get yourselves to the Northern Ireland final, the plate final this year for intermediate. And so I suppose for yourselves winning that and winning it the way you did,
yeah,
with so much character and grace and tactics and skill,
mm-hmm.
I was just delighted for you, you know,
mm-hmm.
And that was made me very, very proud to see, you know, a good group of girls who were so close to win that. And I know, as I said to you, 20 year, or 10 years earlier, I'd won the same thing with my school.
Yeah.
So it was quite nice to see how what can happen after, you know, some
mm-hmm.
history repeating itself. So
yeah,
I'm very proud of you winning that this year.
Is there anything else you'd like to achieve with your sport?
For myself, I suppose I keep winning. You know, I like to see the club I'm involved in, obviously Newry Ladies Netball Club. I'd like to see us being promoted into possibly, maybe not in my playing career time, but up into the big leagues, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a lot of potential there. There's a lot of work that goes on outside of just what happens on the court. And we're developing and we're working. And I think with a very strong junior club that we have, we can get there. So I'd love
yeah.
to see in netball, Newry to be one of, you know, a more developed club team, or,
yeah.
you know, more better potential,
yeah.
or to use our potential is what I mean, sort of. So I'd love to see us, you know, challenging more for some of the more senior titles. Would be fantastic,
mm-hmm.
and I think we could do that.
Yeah.
Anything else more developed? I'd love to see maybe possibly more development in the primary area. You know, the underage, you know, under 12s primary
yeah.
area. You know, netball.
Because there's not much,
Lara,
yeah.
as you know, and you know, so that's why some other schools possibly, or clubs, or even. Other sports have the head start on netball
mm-hmm.
because they do have a lot of target of that area,
yeah.
and also it's not just, you know, netball is a girls' sport, but you know there's a lot of the skills that is for boys as well. So there could be something in linked in there for some of the
yeah.
other sports that could just generic fundamental movement skills. We could do
mm-hmm.
something that can develop sports players and then funnel them all into different clubs or sports that they want to do. So I'd love to see maybe with more development in the primary end,
yeah,
and especially
yeah.
in the Newry area,
mm-hmm.
it would be great to see that just develop and improve.
Yeah. What advice would you give to young people looking for a career in sport?
I suppose what I would say to anybody who looks for a career in sport is to take opportunities, Sarah. You know, yourself, you've taken up so much opportunities yourself,
yeah.
you know, and that's confidence, you know, and good support from your mummy and daddy and from your teachers and everybody else
mm-hmm.
around you. And I think that young people who think that's what I want to be involved in sport, they need to go and take those opportunities that come onto their, you know, onto their lap, or go and look at those opportunities, because there's so much support in Newry. They just have to take those on board. So the other advice would be, if they have a mentor, if they have somebody, a teacher or a coach or maybe an older member of their family, somebody who is involved in sport and can sort of keep the confidence up in them, because sometimes if you get a knockback, it can, you know, set you back
yeah.
a long way. But if you have somebody who's cheering your corner, somebody who's your confidant that you can explain, do you think this is the right thing? It's sometimes nice to have a soundboard.
Yeah.
And if somebody's looking for a career in sport, sport's so vast, there's so many different careers that you can have in sport, that somebody needs to take and look at every avenue, because sport has so much to offer them. So they should really look and see what area they want to get into
yeah.
and try everything, you know.
Yeah.
And I think at your age, you should be trying everything, not just limiting yourself to one sport possibly
mm-hmm.
or one career in sport. Look at all the different things, because sport's ever changing, as we know, and everything's going to get better. You know, we just had the Olympics a couple of years ago, we've obviously had the Commonwealth Games a few years ago,
yeah.
everything's developing as we go along. So there's going to be loads more careers in sport.